Welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to use Illustrator and Firefly to create typography such as this one. Just to mention it in advance, you do not need to use Illustrator for this. You can use pencil on a piece of paper, or you can use Photoshop or any app you like to get some kind of structure reference that you can use in Firefly to tell Firefly the details of what you want to get. We need two things for this. We need a structure reference that tells Firefly where everything needs to be placed, and in the case of text also what kind of text we want in it, because Firefly, such as most AI generators, cannot do anything with text, so it doesn't know text, the concept of it. It's just shapes for it. So we need to tell it what we want to have in it, and we use a structure reference for this. And then we also need a style reference that tells Firefly the details of what this should look like. So in this case, that liquid kind of look with the bubbles in it. First of all, I'm going to generate that bubbly style reference, and we're going to Firefly, and I'm going to just enter that prompt. So this is the prompt I used: a bubbly, translucent, stirred liquid, view from above in violent orange and with small white bubbles. Let's just generate that and let's just see what we get from it. This can take a while, and maybe you need to input that prompt or variations of it quite often, so in order to get what you want. But this one up here looks quite nice, so this is quite similar to the thing I want to get. And also this one, kind of like bright colors, and that's what I want to have. But if you want to go into the other directions, try that. And if you don't like any of them, then generate a new one, or you can also refine your prompt using all of these inputs. Just go on all for the effects, and then you can configure whatever you like, and there are a lot of options in there. So we're going to leave that alone for a moment, and let's just generate that text that we want to have. I have made it in different fonts to use, but I think this might be too fine in here. This perhaps doesn't work, so we're going to use this one here. And it needs to be kind of square, so I've used it in this way, and let's just take a screenshot because that's the quickest way to get it into Firefly. Just make a screenshot, and then let's go into Firefly again and let's combine all of that. So of course photo is correct here. That should have been changed to a different option in the first prompt, and we're going to keep it like that. So now we want the structure reference, and we're going to upload an image, which is the screenshot, this one. I'm going to upload that. And now it also tells us that we need to have the copyright, and I have created that, so of course I have the copyright. And then of course, we need to adjust the strength. So we want to have that layout exactly like that. So strength needs to be to the right. And then also we need to upload an image for the styles. And that is now in my downloads folder. And I'm going to use that one here. So let's upload this. And again, we can adjust the visual intensity and the strength like this, and you can experiment with that. And then let's also go in here, and I'm going to set this to landscape so we get a slightly wider image. And then let's just generate this and see what we get. Again, this can take a while, and again, you might need some more generation cycles, and maybe you need a lot of them in order to get what you want. So this is kind of a random process, so you cannot rely on it. Sometimes it matches in the first or second take, and sometimes you sit hours and watch it generate. And you see, this is already, you know, these two are off. That's not what I wanted. These two are getting closer, but not really what I wanted. And in order to get it more like what I wanted, I think I need to refine the reference, the structure reference. So it puts some of these bubbles inside of those letter shapes, but that's not really what I wanted. It looks like the letter shapes are kind of containers for the bubbles, and that's not what I wanted. I'm going to download that anyway because it's kind of interesting. And this one as well, maybe I can use that sometime. So if you find anything interesting, download it because you might never get it again. So let's go back to Illustrator. And what I really want is bubbles along the edges of those letters. And in order to refine that, we are going into the details. So what we can do is, of course, use a dashed or dotted line, but we can get even more from that. So let's first of all set some color to these letters. I'm going to set this one to white, and let's just apply a stroke to that, and then let's have some purple ones and maybe this one in darker purple, and then let's have again an orange one. And to close this off, we're going to set this to white again, but let's apply a purple line, a purple stroke to that. And again, let's just make that stroke dotted like this, and this stroke as well. We're going to make it dotted just like this. Okay, so these are the kind of dots I can get, but they do not look random. So we want them to look random. And in order to get that, what we can do is make a circle. I have already prepared that one, so it's just a black circle. And then let's go to the brushes and drag that into the brushes panel. And it doesn't take it. Let's try that again. No. So then what we're going to do is expand this shape, and then it will do it like this. We need a scatter brush. And then let's set them all to random here. We do not need to set the rotation to random because round won't change anything. And then make random size and kind of random spacing to this, and also like this here. Okay. And then what we can do with this here is go to the appearance panel. So there's the type, the text object. Add a new stroke to it and make that orange and apply this brush. Now you see it's kind of wild. So let's go into the brush again. That's because of the scatter options, and that is too much here. So that needs to be a lower value like this. Okay, that's much better. And then let's go in here again. They are just so large. Okay. And then we can duplicate this stroke and set one of them to a different color like this. And then also what we can do, while this is selected here, click on this button and change the options. So like this, and maybe have some more spacing so they don't overlap each other too much. Okay, I'm going to move that one to the side, and then we can go on with our structure reference. So let's take another screenshot of this, like so, and let's go back to Firefly and upload this screenshot. So in here we've got the screenshot like this, and then let's generate this. And again, it will analyze it, and let's see what it will get us, like so. And you see we've got all these nice bubbles, and this one looks quite nice, this one as well. So I'm just going to download those. I do not like that very much, but we can go even further. So you still don't like it. Now there's something else you can do. Let's go back to Illustrator, and then let's make a copy of this. And in here, what we're going to do with this one, we're going to set the fill of all of those to none. So this is just the bubbles. And then I'm going to select this one and delete those two. And then what we can do is go to Effect, 3D and Materials, and let's inflate this. So we're going to add some 3D to it, like so. Set the volume a little lower. And then let's go into the materials, and I want this to be really bright and shiny, so the roughness needs to go. And then we need to have the lighting, and I want to have it from the top left. And let's get more intensity. And then of course let's turn on the ray tracing, like this, so we really get that shiny look. And then what we can do is add the bubbles to it, like this. And then let's close this and take the next screenshot, like so, and go back to Firefly. And of course, again, we're going to upload this. So another refinement of our template structure image, and let's just generate here. And it violates the user guidelines, so that's kind of bad. I'm going to upload one that worked. I have used that already. I have tried that. And let's generate this again, like this. And now, of course, you can combine that with those options in here. So we can put some movements to it. Perhaps you can put the synth wave on it to get different renderings of those bubbles, perhaps. And then we have the themes. And in here, what we can try is maybe the psychedelic look. That might give us some nice things, or this splash. And the techniques is, of course, photography. That is okay. And in the effects, you could try neon or ultraviolet. Let's try neon, and let's generate that again. And this will give you some differences in the details of those bubbles, and maybe some differently popping colors. But now it's really important, you can't really judge those results from those miniatures. So I'm going to generate a new one that I didn't like any of these. And we can then download one of them and check out those details, because in these miniature images. You just can't see that. Let's download this one and then this one, and we're also going to download that one, and let's take a look at them. So there are some details around those bubbles which are important when you turn on those options, and they might make a huge difference. So you might need to actually download those images in order to judge if that has worked or not. So this is how these references work.